everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel Study with Soumya. Make sure to subscribe this channel if you haven't subscribed till now. This channel is going to be very helpful for you, so make sure to subscribe. Also, when subscribing the channel, don't forget to turn on the bell icon so that whenever I'm uploading any video, you can get the notification regarding that. So don't forget to subscribe as well as turn on the bell icon. Also, be a part of our Telegram channel. The link for the Telegram channel is given in the description, so you can join us from there. Also, you can search us by our name. The name of our Telegram channel is Placement Coding. So just be a part of our channel. Well, in this video, we are going to discuss about the important topics that you should cover for Mindtree interview. So this is the experience of a selected student. So that will definitely help you to understand that what is going to be the difficulty level, what sort of questions you can expect, and accordingly you can prepare, right? See, I'm not saying that definitely only these sort of questions they will ask you, because it sometimes depends on your technical skill set as well, on your project as well, and different things that you have done, and it varies from student to student. But at least you will get some kind of idea, you will get some kind of confidence whether you are aware of the questions that were asked to the candidate or not. So that is definitely be very helpful for you. So do watch the complete video. Also share this video among your friends as well who are having Mindtree interview in upcoming days. First of all, congratulations to all the students who made it up to the interview, and I definitely wish for all of you that will be able to clear the interview as well. So all the best from my side. So without any delay, let's start with the questions now. So first of all, the most basic question that you will get in all the interview, that is, tell me about yourself. So the first question that is asked in every interview, that is, tell me about yourself. So you know that first impression is the last impression, right? And you have to be very crisp and concise in that particular answer. The most common mistake that students do is that, suppose if the interviewer is asking to me that, Soumya, please tell me something about yourself. So definitely I should not say something like this. Good morning, good afternoon, like whatever the time is. Good afternoon, sir. My name is Soumya Awasthi. So he knows my name, right? So I don't have to repeat the same thing. So specifically, like, just remember this, if the interviewer is taking your name, so you don't have to mention your name again. So you can start with like the location you belong to, and you are currently pursuing BTech degree in whatever branch it is, you can mention that. And if needed, you can mention your BTech score as well, right? Please don't go into like 12th marks and 10th marks and so many stuff. Just simply mention your technical skill set, the programming language you are aware of, and any technology in which you are currently working. You can mention your project, the internship you have done, any, and that's it. Yeah, that will be enough. You don't have to tell a story there. And for sure, please don't mention any of your family background or so. If they're asking, then only you have to mention. Well, these sort of things they do ask in HR round only, so that's not a concern. So just prepare a crisp answer for that particular question. Well, according to the thing that you have mentioned in tell me about yourself in the skill set, suppose you mentioned about Java, or you mentioned about any core subject that you are good at, for example, operating system, database or so. So they will frame the questions from these particular topics only. It's not like they are randomly going to ask anything from you. Core subjects are like common. So if you're from electronics branch, so whatever subjects you are having, so from that they can ask. If you're from computer science, so definitely they will ask you from core subjects like operating system, database, networking. So you cannot say, you cannot blame that, okay, so I haven't mentioned this in the part of tell me about yourself, because they are your subject, you must have read them, right? So talking about the experience of that particular candidate, so the questions that were asked, so first of all, the things started from a basic one, like difference between the loops, for loop, while loop, and which one you would prefer, like this. And then something related to sorting was asked. Sorting, that is very important. So like the question was asked that, what kind of sorting algorithms do you know? Can you please explain them? So first of all, if you are not aware of all the sorting algorithm, you can mention a few, that's not an issue. But the thing is that just be confident with whatever you are saying. It's not like you always have to be 100% accurate, but yes, you have to be confident. That is what matters. right? So just prepare with the time complexity and all sort of sorting algorithms. Also, they can ask you coding question as well. Coding question. I'm not saying they will definitely ask, but they can ask you. They can give you some sort of problem. They can ask you about the approach that if suppose that is the case, this is how the array elements are arranged and you have to make that particular pattern. So what will be your approach? They will definitely give you some time to think about it. They will ask you about the logic, or in some instances, they can even ask you to write the code for that particular. Okay, and be prepared with some basic coding questions. Basic coding questions in the sense like prime number, GCD, LCM, and strong numbers, Armstrong number, palindrome number. These are the basic coding questions that anyone can ask you in the interview time. So just be prepared with the basic coding question. And that is very, very important. Oops. No matter which company you are applying for, I have told you many, many times that oops is very, very important. So I have made one playlist also regarding oops. So if you want, you can just go through it. So this playlist contains the interview questions that you can expect in your interview. So from the oops topic, so just go through it once. So that is very important. Oops features like is abstraction or so. Even they can ask you to implement abstraction using a particular programming language in which you are comfortable in. So like these questions are very common, like is function overloading. What is that? Function overloading, function overriding. They can ask you the difference, that what's the difference between both of the two. Right, so just be sure that you are aware of the function overloading and overriding, what's the difference, and all sort of thing. Also, sometimes they can ask you from advanced data structure as well, that is binary search tree. Like basic they will ask, or sometimes it depends on the mode of the interviewer, they can go into depth as well. So if you are 100% confident about the things, then only reply. Otherwise, then only give your answer. Otherwise, you can simply mention that, I don't know, ma'am, and I don't know. So I will definitely look into this. I will definitely read about this after the interview. You can mention something like this, or you can simply say that, I don't know, sir. Instead of making the stories out there, instead of giving incorrect answer, you can simply mention, because you know that BST aapko nahi aata hai, to aap usme कुछ गलत बताओगे तो that will definitely put a bad impression, right? तो आप directly मना कर दो. अगर एक दो question अगर आप नहीं बता पा रहे हो तो that's not an issue, that's common. It's not like you have to answer each and every question, right? So the experience, the candidate whom experience I'm sharing right now, so even she was not able to answer 2 to 3 questions, and like she was selected. Okay, so it's not like you have to be genuine and you have to be confident at the time of interview. And it's not just for Mindtree interview I'm saying, but any company interview that you are giving. I'm not saying that for every question you are saying, I don't know, definitely that's not a good idea, right? So yeah, that's the thing. So a brief of this, like after going through the whole experience, mainly see, data structure is a very common part, like sorting algorithm, searching algorithm, they are just common. So definitely you will get questions from them. Some coding questions you can expect based on array. So the student got the question based on array. So you can expect some question based on array. Some basic coding questions, like they are very common, that is prime number, GCD and all. Oops, again, that is very important. Some correlated question they can also ask you regarding operating system or DBMS. Not very tough, but just a basic question will be there. Like you can get the question from transaction, dat log, and all sort of stuff. And yeah, that's it. See, the whole conclusion of the interview is that along with that preparation, you have to be confident at the time of interview. And please, if you don't know anything, you know that you are not aware of it, then simply say a no instead of giving an incorrect answer, right? So that's the thing. Even now, many students haven't received the results. So maybe a case that they are not selected. So instead of ki hoping ki aapka result aayega and having thoughts in your mind, I would suggest ki you should start preparation for other companies. And if result aata hai, that is very good. Congratulations from my side. Otherwise, aap koi hope na rakho. Even I do think that अगर कंपनी सिलेक्शन मेल भेज रही है देन इट शुड सेंड रिजेक्शन मेल एज वेल, बिकॉज कैंडिडेट्स का होप जुड़ा होता है मेल से कि यस मैं सिलेक्ट होऊंगा या मैं सिलेक्ट होंगी. सो इस तरीके से एक मेल उन्हें रिजेक्शन का भी भेजना चाहिए जिससे कि आपका होप खत्म हो जाए, आप अपना कहीं और प्रिपरेशन चालू करो. वेल अबाउट दिस वी कैन नॉट डू एनीथिंग, बट डेफिनेटली जिनको अभी तक नहीं आया है तो आ जाए तो दैट इज़ गुड ऑब्वियसली. अदरवाइज आप दूसरी कंपनी का प्रिपरेशन करो इंस्टेड ऑफ वेटिंग कि कब आएगा मैंट्री का रिजल्ट, राइट. So this was the whole thing regarding Mindtree interview experience of the candidate. And see, most of the questions you will get from these sort of topics only. So definitely I think that video will be very helpful for you. And for those students who are from other branches, so just be prepared with your core subjects as well. Definitely they can ask you from your core subjects. They can ask you about project also. I forgot to mention that. Project is also very important, that whatever project you will mention, or even they can ask you, have you done any project in fourth year or so. So just be prepared with your project, just be well versed with your project and the questions that you can expect on your project. Suppose you have done this on Android, so they will definitely ask you questions related to that particular thing. They will ask you that how your project is working and what is the real life application of your project. And so said these basic kind of questions you can expect from their side. And yeah, if you have done any internships, so from that also they can ask that what you have learned and all these different things. So according to me, that won't be very difficult. So if you are clear with the basic part and data structure is good, so definitely you will be able to clear that. And all, and above all these things, just be confident, just revise all. See, agar aapka interview jaldi schedule ho raha hai to aap kuch naya taiyar mat karo, because you don't have time. Aapko jo aata hai aap usko ek bar confidently sara revise kar lo, jisse ki aap aisa na ho kuch naya yaad karne ke chakkar mein jo aata hai usko bhi aap galat kar do ya usko bhul jao. To jo aata hai usko aap acche se preparation kar lo, kyunki time agar kam hai to, अगर आपका इंटरव्यू जल्दी शेड्यूल हुआ है तो, राइट. सो इस तरीके से आप प्रिपरेशन कर सकते हो. एंड समटाइम्स इट्स अबाउट लक एज वेल. कभी कभी होता है कि आप जिसका बेस्ट प्रिपरेशन करते हो उसमें नहीं होता है, और जब बेस्ट प्रिपरेशन नहीं करते हो तब हो जाता है. तो समटाइम्स इट्स लक एज वेल. तो इवन दो सी, फॉर किसी भी एग्जाम के लिए ऐसा सोच के मत चलो दैट आई एम गिविंग दिस फॉर क्रैकिंग इट और सो. यू विल डेफिनेटली गेन एक्सपीरियंस. Even I used to fill the forms for different companies, even though I'm placed. But just for experience itself, I used to give the exam. I don't care that what is the job location and so. But what I care is that at least I will get some kind of experience. I'll be able to assess myself. This will be a kind of self-assessment that whether I was able to clear that or not. So, pata to chalta hai that hum kitne pani mein. तो इट्स नॉट लाइक कि सिर्फ प्लेसमेंट के लिए ही आपको एग्जाम देना, आप जिसके लिए भी एलिजिबल हो जस्ट एग्जाम देते रहो. ओके, सो या दैट्स द थिंग. थैंक यू सो मच फॉर वॉचिंग दिस वीडियो. एंड गाइज, अगर जिसका नहीं हुआ है, इट्स नॉट द टाइम टू रिग्रेट ऑन द थिंग. अभी बहुत अपॉर्चुनिटीज आएंगी एंड डेफिनेटली, तो ये रिग्रेट है ना, इसको हार्डवर्क में कन्वर्ट करो एंड जस्ट डू योर बेस्ट. थैंक यू फॉर वॉचिंग दिस वीडियो. स्टे सेफ, स्टे हेल्दी. बाय बाय.